All right, so welcome everybody. So we're going to do some more examples with the hydrogen atom here. Okay, the example we're looking at today is going to be the wave function here, where we're looking at where are the radial and orbital nodes, or angular nodes, of this wave function, right, the 3pz orbital, okay. So, right, the thing to note, right, if I want to find where a node is, right, I need to look at, say, like, when is psi of r, you know, theta phi equal to zero, right? When is this wave function equal to zero? That is where my nodes are going to be, right? Because a node is just defined as when a function is equal to zero, okay? So that's what we need to basically try to solve, right? And we can note here that our wave function, right, has a radial part and an angular part, right? And I can split those up, right? Because I'll have this radial part of the wave function times this angular part, right? And the theta can be zero at certain points, right? And the r can be zero at certain points, right? And so I can look at, to find the radial nodes, I can just look at the radial part of the function. To find the angular nodes, I just look at the angular part of the wave function, right? And it doesn't really matter these constants out front, because we're looking at when does the wave function equal to zero, right? So multiplying by a bunch of constants is just multiplying zero by a bunch of constants, which is just zero. So we do not really care about these constants. So we can kind of ignore those things, right? All right. So, so let's focus on the radial part first. So for the radial part of the wave function, right, we started off with, right, the radial part of the wave function is 6r over a naught minus r squared over a naught squared. And all of this is multiplied by e to the minus r over 3a naught, okay? And we're wondering, when does that equal zero, right? That's what we're curious about. So the exponential term here, right, use like a different color here. All right, so this exponential term, right, this equals zero when r goes to infinity. Okay, not really relevant, not really important, not really caring. That's not really where a node is located. So basically we can, you know, divide this term out, if you will, to the side, right? Ignore this term, however you want to think of it, right? And really, we just care about when does this equal zero, right? And so, going to solve that, right? We have 6r over a naught minus r squared over a naught squared. Man, I'm going to get better at writing on this tablet, I promise, okay? And that equals zero, okay? So I'm just going to multiply both sides by a naught squared, right? So multiply both sides by a naught squared, okay? To get 6r a naught minus r squared equals zero. Divide everything by r, and that will give us, right, 6 a naught minus r equals zero, right? So our node is at r equals 6 a naught, okay? So this is where our radial node is, right? Our radial node is at r equals 6 a naught, okay? Right. And I'll just note here, I'm posting these videos of working out these solutions, right? But I also will have the typed up solutions that I normally have in the lecture slides posted online as well. So, you know, if it's kind of difficult seeing what I'm writing out here, right, you can look that up as well, right? So, all right. So now we need to do the angular node, right? And so for the angular node, right, the angular part of our wave function is just cosine theta, right? That's it, right? So there's no phi dependence, right? So there's no fee like nodes, if you will, right? No values of fee that are giving us a zero wave function. It's just theta dependent here, right? And so, right, cosine of theta equals zero, right? That happens, right, only when theta is equal to, say, pi over 2 or minus pi over 2, okay? So when theta is equal to pi over 2 or minus pi over 2, that is when our wave function is going to have a node in the angular part, right? So these are, this is our angular node, okay? So that's our angular node, is when theta is pi over 2 or minus pi over 2, right? And, okay, and that's it. Found the radial node, found our angular node, okay? And that's it, all right? So now for the next example,